Now, when economics is translated as Arthashastra, and when we say Arthashastra, Chanakya comes to our mind. Chanakya Arthashastra, Chanakya Niti. And really, Arthashastra is used casually to mean both economics and politics. But when you actually read the Arthashastra, you realize he doesn't really talk about marketing or sales or business development. He's more interested in kingship and legal issues. Now, where did this concept come from? Around this time, that is roughly 2000 years ago, Indian thought is classified as dharma, artha and kama. Dharma is about governance, artha is about economics, and kama is about art and pleasure. And shastras are written to explain about it. So there's dharma shastra, artha shastra, kama shastra. And Chanakya becomes very famous because he's writing the artha shastra, which deals more with politics and legal matters than with day-to-day economics. It's really, the economic part is less and the political part is much more. Now, Chanakya is not the first writer of Arthashastra. When he's writing, he's referring to writers before him. He's referring to Brihaspati, the guru of the Devas. He's referring to Shukracharya, who is the guru of the Asuras, which means he's learning from both people, Brihaspati and the Devas, and Shukracharya and the Asuras. So it is, you know, I keep repeating to people that Dev and Asur, the battle between them is not a moral battle, it's not between good and bad. It is between people who have a lot of wealth, the Devas, the entitled ones, and the Asuras who feel someone has tricked them, cheated them, stolen their wealth. They are the Asuras who live under the earth. And this is the conflict even today's society, haves and have nots. People who have all the wealth with them or seem to have all the power with them have cornered all the wealth, that 1%. And then you have the Asuras who feel that, you know, that wealth has to be not been properly distributed. So Chanakya Arthashastra in a way deals not so much with wealth generation. I mean, there are a few chapters on that, but more of wealth distribution. What is the role of a king, for example? A king's role is to create an ecosystem where wealth can be found, where wealth can be generated. He creates an ecosystem where this generated wealth is properly distributed. This is broadly what Arthashastra does. It talks of a king and his sovereignty, and a good king is someone who enables wealth generation and who facilitates fair wealth distribution. That's the purpose of a king. So king is closely tied in with wealth and economics. If a king follows dharma and his good governance, Lakshmi comes into his kingdom. That is a good king.